Yo, what up, y'all? Fill me in today? Oh my goodness, y'all. I'm teaching y'all how to become 1v1 demons, you feel me? Y'all about to be gods. But hey, make sure y'all watch the video through and make sure you take in every single tip. I promise. This is a banger, bro. But hey, listen, I promise by the end of this video, y'all about to be the best 1v1er, so you just gotta pay attention, you feel me?
I bet. So the first tip I'm gonna be teaching y'all is learning how to read your opponent. And if you don't know what I mean by that, it's basically just learning what your opponent does in certain situations, you feel me? Also, what kind of moves they do and what kind of shots they take. Like, if I'm playing somebody and after the first round, all they went for is low ground shots, I'm not gonna give them low ground shots no more, because that's what they love going for, you feel me? This tip is all about making an enemy feel uncomfortable, you feel me? So make sure you don't let them play how they want to play. But yeah, that's basically it for the first tip. If I see my enemy does a certain play style, try to do different stuff to counter it, you feel me? And if I see my enemy shoots me a lot when I do a certain move, stop doing that move instantly, you feel me? It's not gonna get you nowhere. For the next tip, is pretty simple. It's basically just learning how to get angles and like reading what kind of moves your opponent does. To learn angles, you just have to learn what side they're not protecting, you feel me? So if you see that they're not protecting their left side, boom, you feel me? That's a free shot for me. Instead of just following him from behind or following him from the side he's protecting, I'm going for angles and looking for what is open. Because if you're just chasing them down like this, you're not gonna be able to shoot them, you feel me? Even if they're just doing a simple move like this, you just want to be able to learn how to go to the sides and boom, you feel me, get shots off like that. And for the next tip I'm about to give you out is different for everybody, you feel me? And that tip is finding a sensitivity that works the best with you, you feel me? And this is my sensitivity. I actually changed it from my last video, but you could copy it if you want, you could try it out if you want. But I really recommend finding your own sensitivity that works the best with your muscle memory and that works the best with your thumbs, because everybody holds their controller differently. Everybody has different thumbs, everybody has different hands, we all do everything different. So I recommend finding a sense that fits you perfectly, you feel me? And for tip number two, it's all about 90s, you feel me? 90s are way more important than you think, like really, really important. And I'm not just saying get the fastest 90s, you feel me? It's all about when to use your 90s and how you use your 90s. 90s are so important. Like, whenever you can pull off 90s without getting shot, trust me, do them. Especially if you don't know how to do 90s out of retakes like this, you're gonna get height a lot quicker than someone who doesn't know how to take use of their 90s, you feel me? 90s are so important. It's the easiest way to grab height. It's way easier to do than retakes. And if you could pull them off correctly and not get shot while doing them, you will have height most of 1v1. And when you have height most of 1v1, it's just gonna be an easy dub, you feel me? Another really good tip is just paying attention every time you lose, you feel me? Every single time you lose, you just want to look back and see why you lost and see how you could improve. Because I can tell you right now, a big part of how I got so good at 1v1s is because I sat there and looked at everything that made me lose, and then I stopped doing it, you feel me? So if it was a certain move that would make me always get shot at, I would stop doing the move. If it was a certain playstyle I was doing that just wasn't working, I'd switch up my playstyle. If you look at all the good players, you'll notice a lot of people have their own playstyles, because what works for some people may not work for others, you feel me? Technically, losing helps you a lot, because every time you lose, you could take something from that L and just bring it into a W, you feel me? So if it was a certain type of way you were playing that kept getting you shot, like, just switch it up, you feel me? When it comes to getting better, it's all about trying new things, you feel me? So you gotta try new retakes, you gotta try new moves, you gotta try new starts. You just have to keep trying until you get the perfect mix for your playstyle, you feel me? But the thing is, you can't just 1v1 bots all day and then expect to get better, you feel me? But in the same token, you can't just play somebody that's gonna beat you 24/7, you feel me? You're not gonna learn anything. You don't want to find somebody that's too good, and you don't want to find somebody that's like horrible, you feel me? You just want to find somebody that's around your skill level. All right, so basically now what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna just get into some normal 1v1s, and I'm gonna just talk to y'all while I 1v1, you feel me? And I'm gonna just give you a bunch of tips and tell y'all what and what not to do, you feel me? It's gonna be late. Boom. See how he's playing like more aggressive? People that are playing aggressive, you just want to be able to just be ready for their shot, you feel me? See how he keeps pushing me? I'm gonna be prepared for him to try to push me, because I know he's playing aggressive. See, people, you always have to be aware for shots like that. You always have to be just be ready for to shoot somebody. See, I'm trying to look for angles. Always look for angles. See, that was such a cheeky shot. See how I'm always moving around trying to get angles like that? Always be prepared. When you see someone has an edit on you, always be prepared to just bow, you feel me? Right now, it's a fight for height. I'm just making sure I'm protected. making sure he can't shoot me. See how I just coned him right there? Like I was talking about earlier, cones are very important. Now that I have like a good amount of height, I'm looking for an angle. Boom, easy for me. See, now that I'm on low ground, he's gonna try to like pressure me, but I'ma always be ready for it. Like that, like see how he just tried to break in my box? I was ready for it and I edit on him and bow. It's always important to just stay aware in 1v1s. For me, it's always important to try to know where your enemy is at all times. And you see those stairs? You see those stairs? That's a really underrated strategy that not a lot of people use. See? And like situations like that really just come down to aim. And to get better aim, it's just practice. You feel me? Finding a sense in practice. Like I was saying, those stairs are very important. See how I'm blocking them off with the stairs? That is like so important. I was ready for him to edit. Always be aware of what your enemy and what they're doing. See, I was aware. You can't, that's how I'm aware of everything. I'm making sure I place the walls around my stairs so he cannot cone me in anywhere.